Good morning, Professor.
Ja, guten Morgen. Can you hear me?
Yes, Professor. I can able to hear you.
Wonderful.
Yes.
So?
Professor, I welcome you for this series of webinar. It is one of the objectives of Department of Psychology, American College, Madurai. Thank you for accepting our invitation to act as an expert for the session on youth and mental health. I welcome you, sir. Please, you can take the session. I think I have received questions from the participants in the WhatsApp group. You can start from there itself, sir. I think Sauzanya madam is there. I think she's the one person who can properly communicate with you. I appoint her as a mediator to communicate or pass the message to you, sir. I welcome you, all the participants, for the webinar on mental health and well-being. I think we are the 17th webinar. Today we are having three more webinars at 4 and 5 p.m. in the coming time. You will join, I request you to join that webinars also. And with us, there are a few experts also with us today. I think Damanjit Sandhu ma'am and there are Madhavi ma'am. Yes, there are many of the experts are here. I welcome you all. Professor, you can take the forum now. You can share your experiences now.
Yeah, thank you very much. I'm proud to meet you.
Yes.
And I like to be here. And we got a lot of questions in the meantime.
Yes, Professor.
So, and it is possible that I answer to these questions, but on the other side, it is there are new participants now, and they should have the possibility to ask questions too.
Yes.
So, only to start.
Yes.
I have one question that is really touching me personally.
Okay.
That is a question why I started to do psychodrama. I can tell you a short part of my life.
Yes.
Sir, sorry to interrupt you. We can't see you, sir.
Yes, I see you. Thank you.
Yeah, I think.
Sir, we can't see you.
Yeah, good. Danke. We need you to translate later.
Sir, we can't see your picture. Means we are not able to see you.
Sir, your video is, video is, you have to enable the video, sir.
It's okay?
I think, no, not yet.
No, sir, no.
But yes, now
it's now. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes, sir.
Wonderful, thank you for the hint. So, it was in 1972. In an industrial town in Germany, there the Protestant Church started to create a psychological support by telephone, and they asked me to train the supporters at the phone. And so I didn't know how I can do that, because we could not able to hear, sir. Why not?
I can hear you, sir.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Somebody wrote me that he cannot hear me.
He can hear you.
Okay, that's fine. Hello. So, I heard that an American professor would come to Germany and this professor was a student of Jacob Levi Moreno. I hadn't heard from him before, but I decided to go to her seminar, and she demonstrated psychodrama in the seminar. And I was very fascinated by this method. And so at the end of the session, we talked to each other, and she asked me, are you interested in e-training? Do you want to be a student of psychodrama group? And so after the session, I was so motivated. I said, yes, of course, why not? And so I started a psychodrama study. And she was American. She could not speak German very well. And so she needed a translator. And I started to be her translator. So we worked together for a longer time. So I had the possibility to travel into different countries where she was invited and where she trained psychodrama groups. And then it was in 1979, I started to lead my own training groups. And I became a teacher of psychodrama. And because I was used to travel to different countries, I used the possibility and my connections, and I had a lot of seminars in different countries, and I was traveling around Europe. And then later I was asked to come to Russia, and then I stayed there for a longer time. The last 14 years I was working in Russia, and I was working there as a professor of clinical psychology, and I created there an institute for teaching psychotherapies. So we had the possibility also to train in psychodrama. So, but during the whole time, I was confronted with different psychotherapies. I'm specialized on psychodrama, that's right, but I'm also used to deal with other therapies. For example, this telephone consultation doesn't work with psychodrama. So you need very often non-directive therapy, talking therapy. And so I started to train Rogers, and we had a lot of training sessions in non-directive psychotherapy. And then if you come in contact with Rogers, you start to learn about humanistic psychologies. And at the end, I changed the classical psychodrama into another method. It is called humanistic psychodrama now. And the main difference between classical psychodrama and humanistic psychodrama is that classical psychodrama is more combined with psychoanalytic theories and some theories of Moreno about spontaneity. And so I'm not really, I don't really agree to these theories. I think psychodrama is a special possibility to learn human positive behavior, and you can train your abilities to do something together with other people, and you are working in a group, and so it is more a social learning process. Psychodrama leader is a teacher in the group. So, any question? Yeah? Vanamali, some more?
Yeah, it's actually it's more of a technique of used only in group therapy. Is that psychodrama is used for individual setting also? Face to face, one interaction, that is the client and counselor also, or it is only used for group therapy?
So we need a translation because the voice is very
Sir, yes, I'm there.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, wonderful.
Ma'am is asking, is psychodrama used only in group therapies? Can it be used for individual counseling also?
Psychodrama is used in very, very different arrangements. I myself, if I lead psychodrama, I lead it in a group. But the methods are also usable if in an individual therapy. Yeah, for example, the method of role reversal, you can use in individual therapy, of course, but that is not psychodrama. Role reversal is not psychodrama. So I believe that the changing process of the personality is depending on the interaction with other people, with other persons. If you concentrate on one individuum, it is only the interaction between the therapist and the client. And only in this constellation is a changing of behavior possible. But if you have more people around, you have much more flexibility and many more possibilities to learn behavior, because you get feedback from 5, 6, 7, 8 people or more. And you are staying together with these people for a longer time. Psychodrama is not only 1 hour. Usually psychodrama sessions are about 1 year. And the group is meeting every week. So, we got another question now. Von Vijay, an alle. I don't know where it is. The problem I see with psychodrama now is that all okay? Good? You can hear me?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, good.
I can hear you.
Psychodrama is developed in many directions. For example, using in theater, or is using to make spontaneous role playing. So psychodrama is only in few cases used as psychotherapy. And I'm a teacher of psychotherapy, not of role playing, and not of theater, and not of doing some spontaneous things I used psychodrama to treat illness, mental illness. And I know, because of my experience now, I'm doing it for more than 40 years, that psychodrama is very useful and very effective in treating mental illnesses. But you need a very good therapist to do it. Not just a person who makes role playing, that is not enough. You must be a very good trained psychologist to do it. You must know about psychopathology, and you must know a lot about psychotherapies. And so that means to do psychodrama as a therapy, you need to be trained about 6 years usually. You cannot learn psychodrama in one weekend. And it is also not possible to visit one seminar and then you are a psychodrama therapist.
Sir, can you tell us how it works with an example?
How it works?
Yeah, with an example. Like I come to you with depression. Yeah. Yeah, I have depression.
Yeah. No, you don't. For the past. You don't have a depression.
You are, no, I.
You are yourself, and sometimes you feel depressive.
Yes, I feel. I'm coming with that an.
That is the difference. If you define yourself as yes. depression, I say hello. How are you, depression? And you say, "Oh, I'm so bad." Yeah. Yes, I see.
I'm coming, yeah.
You have a better feeling about yourself, yes?
Saujanya.
Mm-hmm.
Saujanya.
Yeah, hello?
Yes. Sir, I just wanted to have an example which you already treated a child or any adolescent in regard to any mental illness. Live example, can you share?
Using psychodrama.
Yeah, yeah. It is very difficult to do psychodrama with children. Many people believe that it is easy.
Okay.
Because children like to play and like to make role playing. But that is not enough to change mental illness. So that means you need to know a lot about child psychology, and you need a lot of you need to know a lot about psychopathology of children, and then you can use your knowledge and deform your knowledge in special methods, and you can work with psychodrama methods if you have the right theory about it. So not all illnesses are with the same background and with the same structure. So that means you need to adapt to the situation always in a new way. For example, working with aggressive children is very different from working with depressive children. And it is, one person asked for a disorder, for eating disorder, for example. We have very different concepts to work with these different illnesses, with this different for example, if a young person has an eating disorder, mm, you cannot work with this young person in ambulance therapy. You need to have control about the surrounding. That means they need to go into a special hospital and need to stay there for a longer time. I don't know whether you have these special hospitals in India. I don't have information about it. But here in Germany, we have special institutions. They work with young people and with special disorders. And they are specialized, for example, on eating disorders. And so there was one question about the disability adaptation. So there was a question, how can you find out whether there is a mental illness developing with children? And I want to give you four hints how you can find out whether there is illness in, there is danger of getting ill with the children. First is that the child starts with an emotional withdrawal and with a higher sensitivity. It is more reacting to normal situations, overacting, and losing of interest, and starting to be depressive, not reacting with emotions on situations, shyness, developing the wish to suicide, and very often you find constraints with the children. And that is the first cluster of indications for a psychic illness. The second cluster is that children start to have fear, not existential fear. They cannot really say what it is, why they have fear, or about what they have fear. They have only a diffuse feeling of insecure. Very often, this is the beginning of a psychotic development, and so you need to be very careful with it. What is more visible and more remarkable is if children are social unadapted, and when they start to behave in a way, it is defined not to the definition is that is not normal, and they behave in an unnormal way, and that is very strange behavior, bizarre, and very often they are very aggressive, and they are loud and uncontrolled, and they destroy things, and that is a third cluster of indications. And the fourth cluster is that they start to to deny social behavior. They isolate themselves, and they start constrained behavior, controlling themselves in that what they are doing. Yesterday we had one participant. He spoke about his hand washing, and I told him that it's okay now because of Corona. But if a 5 or 6 year old child starts to wash their hands 20 times per day, that is irritating. And then you should be notice it, and then it is important that you start to work against it. You can say 10 times it is enough, and you can wash your hand every hour, look to the clock, and don't wash between. So that means you have 4 behavior clusters that show that there is a psychic illness developing with the children. Okay.
4 clusters to understand if there is a psychic illness developing.
There?
Yes. So what is the difference between the first cluster and the last cluster? First one, you said it is emotional withdrawal.
Yes, and developing of a higher sensitivity.
Yes, and fourth one, you said isolation.
Yes, isolation and developing of constraints. That is the fourth point.
Yes.
The third point, third point is the open social mismatch and hostility.
Okay.
Yeah, bizarre behavior and aggressive behavior. The second cluster is to have fear and and get fantasies which make fear, and that you start to develop suicidal ideas. And the first was emotional withdrawal and a higher sensitivity. All clear?
Yes.
Hi everyone, we have 7 minutes 43 seconds left over. So anyone who wants to ask the question can go ahead.
I only want to ask.
Yeah.
Sir, how do we differentiate between empathy and psychodrama?
Psychodrama is a process of group working. And empathy is necessary in a positive human relationship. You cannot understand other people if you are not empathic. That is a general ability people have, and especially in psychotherapy, the empathy is very important. So therapist who is not empathic cannot understand the client, and he needs the client to become empathic. And that is one factor that is also working in psychodrama, of course, but empathy is also working in talking therapy. And if you make behavior therapy and you are not empathic, it will not work. Yeah, it is generally needed. And psychodrama is a very complex process. Empathy is only one small factor inside.
Yes. Got it.
Okay. So, Anjala Bagra asked me questions. There is one. How can you control anger after frustration?
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Yes. You know, it is very normal to get anger after a frustration.
Okay.
That belongs to a frustration that mm-hmm. you, after frustration, react on it. And one of these possible reactions is aggression. Always, if you are frustrated, a special need you have is not fulfilled. And your what you want is to get a satisfaction of your need. And if you don't get it, you start with a behavior, you mean that you get the satisfaction. And very often people think if they are aggressive, they get what they want. Yeah? The reason of war. So they want to be stronger. And you are stronger if you can dominate the other person. And if you are aggressive and you are stronger than the other person, you will get what you want. For example, if you have money and I want your money, and I'm stronger than you are, I can just take your money.
Okay.
And you cannot defend yourself. And the same principle is with frustrations. If you are frustrated, you start with a behavior you believe that will be successful for you. But you will find out that aggression is not the right way.
Yeah.
And only if you learned that aggression is not the right way to get what you want, you start to think about other behaviors, other possibilities. And you will find out that there are other possibilities to get what you want. Okay. And you don't need to be aggressive. Yeah? So if you feel that you are starting getting aggressive, stop and think about how you can manage the situation in another way.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yes.
Cool. About...
Yes, I think we are running out of the time. Probably you could get in touch through WhatsApp. And Professor Hans, I take this opportunity to thank you from bottom of our hearts on behalf of American College Madurai. Thank you so much, sir, for your valuable time and for enlightening us with your knowledge. I hope this continues further. We are looking forward to have more sessions in future. Thank you so much, and all the participants, thank you so much for being so patient and helping us to share so much of knowledge. We are keep looking for more and more webinars. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. It was wonderful.
Thank you,
to
sir.
Have
thank you.
You. Yes.
Thank you for your help.
Yes, sir. And please do type whatever answers, or I mean, whatever questions or queries you have, please do type to WhatsApp group. Professor Hans will be answering. Sir, on your behalf, I'm telling them, thank you so much.
Yes.
We really look forward for future sessions. Thank you.
Yes.
So much.
Thank you so much for your English. I could understand it.
Thank you. Ma'am Subhashree, ma'am, can you put a few words?
Yes, thanks. And Suyanya, thank you very much for your help. Yes?
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Saujanya.
See you again. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye, sir.
Bye.